I'm down in Kent, down on the Kentian Metal Detecting Club, down in gonna do a bit of metal detecting. I'm a late start today, as on foot, got my trusty steed. Can't go wrong with that, I tell ya. So we're here, this is field two. I'm going over there, between those trees, to field one. Wish me luck. See you on the first piece on earth. Right guys, first hole. Well, first hole with a decent signal and some significance. And we've got over here, I did see it and I've lost it again, something green. I still can't see it. There it is. That's a bit of furniture tack, I believe. Yeah. Okay, cool. Kushti. Right, happy with that. See you on the next. Just had this out. I don't know what it is. Like some sort of pin type thing. I don't know, could that even be silver? Looks like I've got a bit of gold gilt on it. Don't know. Yeah, it's definitely interesting. I thought it was a nail at first, but no, I don't know. But I'll check that out later. I'll give it a clean up, and you'll know. Anyway, cool. Sorry about the wind. It's a bit windy around here. The rain's just about to hit, so I shall see you on the next. All muddy. Kushti, happy days in a bit. So, let's have a look. It's about here somewhere. A little bit of lead, that's all it is, it's a little lump of lead. Okay, cool. Lead means life, so happy days. On to the next. See you in a bit. And a dig is never a dig without one. And we have a little four-hole button. Oh, broke. A baton. Oh dear, happy days. Anyway, it's good, buttons are good, because buttons means life, means human activity and all that, so I'm going to find something pucker soon. Come on, hammy gods, universe. Let me find a hammy for the first time in like 2 years of detecting. Anyway, Kushti, cheers guys, see you on the next. I'll get me first clean of silver. And it's an old petrol cap. That was such a good signal. But I see it like that. It was like that. Just sort of a little glint of silver. Oh. Anyway. Kushti. Alright, I'll see you on the next. We've got something green. Excuse the wind if you can't hear me. What do you reckon? I reckon a baton. I love saying it. Baton. Let's have a look. One sec. Rah. Yeah. That's not even that, I don't think, or is it? Yeah, it's like an old button. It's like the face of a baton. Yep, okay. The old Xterra Pro, my little baby, is certainly picking up some more stuff today, so come on. Right. Yeah. 18 and that is. It's so muddy. Quite flat. That's a baton. Alright, okay. cool. Alright, so catch you on the next. Back to the area where I found this earlier. And one of the obstetricians has told me that that could well be a Victorian hairpin. So I'm going to give it a little bit of a clean up. And it could be silver as well. So it's crossed. Spray. This was squirt. Zoom in. Come on, focus. Yeah, looks like there's a bit of a gilding on there. But yeah, so I think that's very much, I think it's right. That's pretty much a hairpin. It could well be Victorian, could well be silver. So I'll do a silver check on that later when I get in. And yeah, happy days. So could well be silver in the hole. Christy, well, that's my most historic find of the day so far. So, and it was one of my first, so happy days. Cool, see you on the next, guys. It's getting dark, I'll be heading back soon. And something green and round. Let's see what it is. Probably another little bit. It's flat on that side. Turn it over. We've got a bit of gilding go. Bugger it. Yeah, that's a button. Another button. It's got some gold gilt. Yeah. Okay. Lots of buttons. I think that might be an ornate one, you know. Okay. All right. A couple more holes, I think, before it gets dark. And then I'll toodaloo. Anyway, catch you on the next if there is one. Peeps, right, back home now. Okay, quick show and tell. So this is just all the little bits of nails and crap and kept this one because I think that's fairly old. I mean, look at that. I do like my old nails. Call me an idiot, but I do. How's that for a lump of lead? Rolled lump of lead. Look at the size of that. Huge. Bit of scrap. I kept this because I thought it had some patterning on it, but it hasn't, so I don't know what that is. Bit of tin. Kept that because it was round and, you know, I wanted to, once cleaned up, see if it had any descriptions on it, but no. This bugger had me going for a minute, gleaming like silver in the mud. But yeah, it's just like an old lawnmower or tractor oil cap, I think, or petrol cap maybe. Okay, lead snot. Another little bit of lead snot. Funny little lead thing. Don't know what that is, but you know, it's got no markings on it or anything, unfortunately. There you go. Found this clay pipe stem. Cool. Old button, no markings on it. Lovely bit of gold gilding, though. Oh, come on. Focus. Oh, anyway, it's got some lovely gold gilding on it when it starts to focus. Yeah. Anyway, that. Another little button, again, no pattern, no good on that one. Gold button, popper button, I think, face. The usual four-hole baton. Bit of leather furniture tack. And this, strange one. So that's a lead front with an iron back, but appears to be a baton. Looks like one anyway. It's weird. Alright. Now. Find of the day was this. Now this is it cleaned up. Yeah, it does appear to be silver. It's got, I don't know if you can see it, it's got like a little rose. It's quite dented, but it's got like a little rose patterning on the top there. It's like a mushroom sort of shape, and I've been told that it could be a Tudor hairpin. So I think it possibly is. I've got a feeling it may well be silver plated. I don't think it's solid silver. It's just not heavy enough. But yeah. Anyway, so if that is a Tudor hairpin, then happy days, a decent bit of history. Anyway, okay, that's it. Sorry to bore you. So just look out for the next video on the next dig, probably next weekend. Cheers, guys. Take it easy. Peace on earth.
And y'all ready for this?